Have you ever wondered why some combines are equipped with dual wheels? What benefits do farmers get from such a solution? How does dual wheels setup impact on daily field work? If you have no idea, I've got you covered. You will find all the answers in today's episode of How Does It Roll? Roll the freaking intro. Combines are divided into classes that are defined by the Association of Equipment Manufacturers. The class of a combine is generally determined by the horsepower, where the higher the horsepower, the higher the class number. Years ago, combine harvesters from classes 6 and lower accounted for over 95% of the market. But global food demand is growing, therefore trends in machinery are changing. Nowadays, combines from classes 7th up to 10th account for more than a half of all combines sold. Weight of the machinery and their load capacity grows with horsepower. At some point, single wheels weren't sufficient anymore. Dual wheels offer more stability and higher load carrying capacity. They also provide increased flotation and less soil compaction compared to single wheels. Why don't we recommend trucks? Machines with trucks are generally heavier and cause deeper soil compaction, especially in comparison to IF or VF technology tires. Trucks are also more fuel consuming than wheels and tires. Not to mention that machines with trucks cost more and trucks maintenance is quite expensive. If you need to travel between fields by road, you are also limited with lower road speeds when using trucks. Throughout the years, we've seen various types of dual wheels on harvesting machinery, but we can differentiate three main groups. The most common solution is so-called dolly duals set. This kit consists of two identical wheels with spherical shape deep pressed discs. There can be a spacer between wheels to straddle the rows or to help the duals clear mud in wet conditions better. Both wheels are faced back to each other and attached to machine through hub bolts. Dolly duals may be prone to cracking, especially in larger machines using 20 bolts pattern hubs. Luckily, Pronar wheels engineers have solved this issue by enhancing the thickness of the disc and making it out of grade 80 steel. It is worth mentioning that Pronar wheels is the only company in Europe that can produce such wheels with large offsets. The second group are straddle dual kits. In this solution, there is an inner wheel which can look just like a standard single wheel. It is mounted onto the machine by hub bolts. There is also an outer wheel with a larger offset that is mounted onto the inner wheel disc on the larger second PCD. Straddle duals are less prone to cracking. Interestingly, this solution can be also found in some four-wheel drive tractors which use the same size of tires on front and rear axle. Last but not least, there are also expanded band straddle dual kits. In this solution, we have two large offset wheels. They have flat, very thick discs. Large offset is achieved by a tube style expander band. Same like in previous solution, an inner wheel is attached to the machine by hub bolts, while outer wheel is attached to inner wheel disc on larger second PCD. The difference is that the second PCD connecting two wheels together is much larger than in previous solution. This option is the most durable one. There are no cracking issues. Interestingly, such wheels can be also found in some of the biggest air carts or anhydrous ammonia carts. There is one more question left. Which solution is the best? There is no right and universal answer to this one. The choice should be based on the type of machine you use, what you use it for, and where. That's it for today. If you have any more questions regarding dual wheels, don't hesitate to contact us. See you next time.
Pronar Wheels. We drive your business.